We're coming to you with another review. This is the NECA 8209 30th anniversary from NECA. Now, it's actually the same as the previous 8209 we've had before. I had this figure a good 5 years or so ago, but of course, just completely welcome to have this figure re-released and back out there. There doesn't seem to be any difference at all with the figure, nothing on the paint or anything. It seems to be exactly the same figure. Same packaging overall, but still pretty damn good. Scales with your regular Robocop from the line. There's been plenty of Robocops released. Let's hope we get some more. But that's it. That's the box. If you've never seen it before, there's the top. And if you want to see the bottom, just for whatever, the person behind that development, Randy Falk, often handling the Twitter account at NECA. Great guy. And all the guys, they're a really good bunch of people at NECA. They really are. They really know their toys and they love them, which is a kind of rarity these days. So let's get a look at Ed 209. In terms of how high he stands, he's just over 8 inches tall, so just a little bit bigger than Robocop himself. But he just looks epic, the way the light is shining off this. Let me move that in just a little bit better. There you go, you can really see the silver. Isn't that a nice effect as you go around? They've just added a lovely paint job onto this. Loads of little greeblies in detail, a little bit of backwash in silver, the red, all the little logos and transfers, wires. Check out those wires in the feet, we'll show them in just a second. But loads of cabling and guns and lots of minute little details in there. Just looks really, really good on this figure. Let me bring it a little bit closer and we'll get into some of the detail. But it's just, it's an epic looking figure. Now, I've got the Hot Toys version of this, which is a great, great figure. But it was a bit of a pain in the ass, the Hot Toys one, because the plastic after time started to, all this kind of rubber that they had in the Hot Toys version started to crack a little and fade. And it really wasn't great, so I ended up having to get rid of the thing. So, but this is good. It's all solid plastic. A little bit easier to store. It's not quite as big as a ridiculous size Hot Toys one, but it also comes with sound. Underneath is some batteries, pre-installed. Just press this button on the side here. Cool is that? The sound of people being murdered. It did say 20 seconds to comply, and then it counts, it goes through like 6 or 7 different statements, but... Really good sound effect, straight from the movie. I think there's one more in there. Pretty good. So there's quite a few sounds in there directly from the movie. Really clean, I have to say. Far better, actually, than the Hot Toys. I feel the Hot Toys had almost kind of slowed down a little bit. It felt a little bit warped, and it was fresh battery, so it wasn't anything to do with that. But sound comes directly out of there. It's really loud, and it just looks awesome, and it's pretty cheap. So I picked this up at DarkSideToys.com. They packed this thing like a baby. There's a link to them and other places. I think they might have sold out by now. They're a huge NECA stalker, so if you haven't bought anything at NECA, you're in for an absolute treat. Check out DarkSideToys.com and the link below to their NECA section, and yeah, they just buy a ton of NECA stuff. And NECA is one of those things, if you don't know, that it's just, they're one of the rare toy companies these days who make really good toys for very, very good prices. So as I promised, just a little bit of a close-up on some of the detail in there. You can see some of the cables and the wires, and as I said, those little greeblies and details and stickers and all sorts of stuff. There's even detail on there, as it does say warning with a little bit of text on that sticker. So it's pretty good overall. Now, he does come with articulation too. He's got flaps. It's always about the flaps up at the top, and that allows these arms underneath to extend out, so there's quite a lot of movement. And then in turn, the forward guns are completely allow them to be moved around. So you get quite a bit of display on this. I mean, he never moved in that way, but even the detail in there on the little ratchets and all the kind of detail of the weathering stuff. I think they've just done such a phenomenally good job in this. And of course, the guns rotate and move around. You can move them up and down. So there's a fair bit of movement. Upper torso part of them, that allows that to move and swivel. There is a little bit of movement at the back that you can kind of nudge that down, I believe. I think you can. Yes, you can. You can move the legs around and they can move that way. And you can also, it's very hard to move them, but they kind of snap up and they snap down. So you make a very audible crunch. You've got to make sure you move them both at the same time. But there's pretty much packed with articulation. There doesn't seem to be anything in the toes, as far as I can see. There's no articulation there. But look, given it seems to be a little bit of a wiggle at the back heel, but I don't think it's supposed to do that. So no real articulation in the feet. But I don't think you need it, to be honest. He stands pretty well, and he looks awesome. So let us know what you think. Pick it up below. It's an old figure, but you know what? It's a classic. So I thought I'd give it a review again. And I say I just bought it again from Dorkside Toys. So why not? That's it from me. We'll see you for more reviews coming right up.